nangyari yon, no, na wala naman siyang birth certificate, no. So yeah,
Chair,
Congressman Fernandez,
parang may problem tayo dito kasi ngayon ko lang na dinigdig yung issue that I learned from the statement of the good chairman that in the last hearing ba po yan, Mr. Chair, that NCR issue that did not issue any birth certificate, no. And according naman sa PSA, nagbase lamang po sila sa issuance ng NCR. Paano po mangyayari yon that NCR never issue any birth certificate while PSA nagbase lang po kayo sa in-issue naman ng NCR? So there must be somebody who is lying between the two of you. Have you invited the NCR, Mr. Chairman? Sa, yung sa ating local civil registrar? Andiyan?
Yes,
Miss, oh yes, ayan.
Rarowena Rarofe.
So, wala kayong issuance, NCR?
Wala po kami record, Your Honor.
Wala kayong record. Wala. Pero sinasabi ng PSA, nagbase sila sa in-issue ninyo. Eh, wala naman silang in-issue, attorney, PSA. How is that so?
Your Honor, we have already submitted the endorsement from the LCR.
No, that's not the question.
Your Honor, the first endorsement which we received from the LCR at that time, actually he's the one who...
How can you verify the authenticity of the documents that were submitted to you from the LCR? Kasi lahat dyan, merong mga tinatawag na security measure eh, that is coming from the different LCR. So, do you have a mechanism of trying to find out the veracity of the transmitted documents coming from the different LCR? Baka itong nangyayari, ito na nangyayari sa buong Pilipinas. Kaya tayo, ang dami ng mga late registration na nagaganap. Mr. Chairman, kasi I really don't know how many cases are there right now. So, attorney, what is the mechanism for you to find out the legitimacy of the documents coming from the LCR?
Thank you. Your Honor, we have sample specimens of the concerned LCR, Your Honor.
What again?
Signature of the LCR, Your Honor, in our database.
Signature of the head of the LCR.
Yes, Your Honor.
So, alimbawa ako galing ako sa Santa Rosa, LCR ko, nag-sign ako, pinadala ko sa inyo, that is already legitimized without verifying, especially when these people are foreigners or napapalusutan kayo sa PSA.
Your Honor,
diba? Kasi napakasimple eh, eto sinasabi ng NCR, wala silang in-issue, tapos sabi nyo galing sa NCR. Kaya, most likely, have they taken their oath, Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
Mga meron ditong kumikita ng malaki sa PSA. And I believe that this is not happening on one certain area. And I believe this is a protracted conspiracy. Well, it's not conspiracy, but somehow, malaki yan itong nangyayaring to dahil ang involved dito mga Chinese. Di ba? And we have to warn you, attorney, huh? You are under oath. And at the same time, the stake of the national security ang pinag-uusapan dito. And you are conniving with the enemy. Dahil nililegitimize natin yung pagiging foreigners nila. Di ba? And yung reason po ninyo na pirma lang, approve na sa inyo, that is a big excuse, ha? Anybody can sign on behalf of the civil registrar. Di ba? Your mechanism of trying to find out the validity of that documents is not acceptable. Imagine, pirma lang. Eko ako pumirma nun. Dinaya ko yung pirma. Tatanggapin nyo na, attorney? Answer. Please answer. Coming from any other LCR, pag nakita mo may pirma na yung head, that's it.
Mr. Chair, can I just interject?
Yes.
With the indulgence of Congressman Fernandez, yes.
Attorney, kailan po kayo pumasok sa PSA?
22, Your Honor.
So 2022.
Yes,
and yung certification na binigay naman ng PSA is tama ba yung date August 31, 2001?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. So is anyone from PSA here today na nagtatrabaho na po noong 2001?
Yes, good morning.
No,
sir.
2001 kasi boss yung August 31 yung ano eh. Binigay yung certification. Am I right?
Yes.
Yes. So anyone from you? From
yes. We already submitted a copy of the endorsement letter coming from the local civil registrar of Mekawayan, Bulacan during the time.
Yes,
so
but yeah. But the problem here now is LCR ngayon po is denying na may record noon na may registry number na 127, instead ang record nila is 127-B77 and different name po yung nakalagay.
Yeah, we also checked po in our microfilm that the name of Stephanie Ong is the registry number 127 is for Stephanie Ong.
But, yeah, kasi naalam lang po natin, tama po si Congressman Dan Fernandez, medyo delikado rin po to, especially kung specimen signature lang ng LCR ang binabasihan nyo. Tapos magiging Filipino citizen rin po kaagad because of the late registration. And now, basing sa sinasabi po ng present LCR ngayon, they don't have any record na pinasa sa inyo noong 2001. That's why I'm asking you, attorney, to be fair lang po sa inyo because this happened 2001 and just assumed office 2022. Kaya po nakita ko po yung itsura nyo, nagugulat po kayo, no? So, ang inaalam lang po natin is ano ba yung mga security measures kasi ayaw na po rin natin maulit din po ito.
Yes, sir. This time po, we are strengthening po yung process of delay registration. Meron po kaming drafted na memorandum regarding this. Based din po dun sa mga suggestion na we need to require the late registrant to appear.
Yes, but ito na po yung case natin ngayon. Sinasabi po ng LCR, walang record sila regarding the Willie Ong. So, what ano na po ang remedy natin sa PSA ngayon regarding the status of the citizenship of Willie Ong na nag-late registration na wala naman po talaga na record nag-emanate doon po sa ating LCR?
Okay. Your Honor, with regard to your question, we have already drafted an endorsement letter to OSG for the filing of cancellation of the birth certificate of Willie Ong.
But aside from that, Mr. Chair, if I may, no? Well, I'm really sorry, no? Bago ka lang pala doon. I really don't know. And that was issued on 2001 pa. May we possibly know, kapag nanggaling sa NCR yung dokumento, what part of your agency received that document?
Actually, may division po concern on the receipt and control.
No, tanong ko lang, anong part ng inyong ahensya ng PSA ang tumatanggap ng dokumento na galing doon sa yung sa LCR, sa local civil registrar? Siyempre, nagpapadala yan ng dokumento, di ba? Sino tumatanggap doon?
PSA.
Hindi nga, anong part ng PSA? PSA
anong
is so
division?
Civil Registration. Different.
Ha?
Civil Registration Division.
Civil Registration
Division.
Sila tumatanggap ng mga birth certificate na dinadala noong mga applicant.
No.
Sila.
No po. Registration at the local civil registry level.
Oo nga, 'di ba? So, okay, sa local, 'di ba? So sinasabi nyo, dinadala pa sa inyo, meron din kayong kopya, 'di ba?
Yes po.
Sino doon sa PSA ang tumatanggap ng kopya ng galing sa civil registrar?
Sa provincial statistics office muna po 'yun.
So provincial statistic
office
sa probinsya muna.
Opo,
sa and then dadalhin sa national.
Yes. They provide po the copy of for the PSA.
So in other words, it's more of a ministerial job on the part of the PSA yung galing sa local civil registrar? Is that what you are trying to imply with us, to us?
Yes, the PSA is the national repository of the documents.
Depository lang kayo?
Yes.
So in other words, lahat na nakukuha na dokumento, eh paano to? Wala nga in-issue ang NCR eh. And then suddenly, meron sa PSA eh. Paano nangyari yon? So depository lang kayo. So, So much more na, Mr. Chairman, the yes, more sir. That we have to investigate this matter. Because what we can see in here is somehow, doon sa PSA mismo, merong isang division dyan na nag-aayos ng mga dokumentong to na peke. Madam, I'm not pointing at you. Kaya don't, ano, huwag kang mag-anta dito. Huwag kang mag-react. Because if you reacted this way, eh baka kasama ka. How long have you been in the PSA?
Actually, almost 40 years.
Ilan?
40 years.
40 years?
And since NSO days.
40 years.
NSO time pa.
Ang tagal mo na doon. You should know everything. 40 years ka na andon. And it happened. Within that 40 years, itong problema na kinakaharap ng ating bansa na maraming foreigners na nalilegitimize, especially yung mga Chinese na ginagawang Pilipino. Are you a part of it? Are you a part of it? Ma'am, I'm asking you. Are you a part of it?
Definitely no.
Hindi kasi nga ma'am, sinasabi ko po eh, depository lang kayo eh, sabi nyo. Kung depository lamang kayo, yung mga dokumento na nanggagaling sa mga LCR, tinatanggap nyo lang. Para kayong isang system, para kayong interface, na pagkatapos na magawa na ng LCR yung kanilang mga dokumento, meron lamang kayong kopya. Depository nga lang eh. Pero unfortunately, in here, nakikita natin, wala silang in-issue, kayo meron. How is that so? There must be a problem in you. Kaya Mr. Chairman, lumalawak yung problema natin dito sa mga foreigners na legitimize. What part of your provision, of your policy that involves the, what do you call this? The provision of yung late registration. Anong parte ng inyong provision na pinapayagan nyo ang late registration? Like for the example of Mayor Alice Guan, 17 years, saka lang siya na-register. How is that so? Why did you allow it? Can you kindly explain on this committee? Anong provision ng PSA na kalabas na pwede tayo magkaroon ng late registration as long as this kind of situation that Mayor Alice Guan
go
have encountered 17 years, tapos niregister natin? Correct, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Siguro 40 years ka doon, nasa PSA ka na. Have you encountered this issue of Alice Go? Late registration? Ano po yung policy po natin sa late registration?
Meron po kami procedure on the late registration. Actually, we consider po na timely ang registration within, kapag na-register siya within 30 days.
Within?
Upon birth po. Dapat na-register siya in 30 days po. So we consider that timely. If na-
so no matter how long you've been in the country, kahit na 30 years ka na, pwede ka pa rin mag-registration. Is that the policy?
Meron pong, yes, meron pong late registration procedure na dapat i-comply po nila yung...
Can you kindly give us the provision of your policy on the late registration? So wala siyang capture na time element. Na for example, kailangan hanggang 5 years ka lang.
Sa ngayon po, wala basta after ng reglementary period, if talaga magre-register po, yun po yung considered na delayed registration.
So, who is the head of that registrar na nag-upload noong mga documents coming from the LCR? Sinong head sa PSA?
Sa ngayon po, meron kaming civil registration service. Na
sino nga po ang head?
Si Assistant National Statistician Marisa Grande.
Ilang taon na po siya doon?
Hindi ko.
Mr. Chairman, can we invite that person from the PSA as well? Because we need to find out the culpability of our government agencies that deal with the approval of the PSA, you know? Kasi nakikita natin dito, baka malaki itong sitwasyon na to, Mr. Chairman. And that's the reason why we wanted to invite those people who are responsible for receiving the copies coming from the LCR. Tingnan po natin yung kung sino ang mga ito. At especially sa province ng sa Banangaling.
May Kawayan.
May Kawayan, Bulacan. Sila yung depository. Sino yung head ng depository nyo? We need to invite them, Mr. Chairman, to shed light on this matter. Kasi ano, kitang-kita po natin na may problema doon sa ano, transmission eh. Kung depository lamang sila, dapat talagang magre-reflect lang kung ano nang gagaling sa mga civil registrar. Pero kung meron ngayon nakakasingit, ang problema nasa PSA. Depository, nasa inyong problema.
Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Fernandez. Just in relation to, before I recognize Congressman Atop, in relation to the question raised by Congressman Fernandez, and before that, I'd like to acknowledge pala the presence of Congressman Gaston Buting. Welcome to the Committee on Dangerous Drugs.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Good morning po sa inyo.
So, from LCR, papunta sa PSA, wala bang kasamang mga supporting documents yun?
Yung submission po ng mga requirements po ay nasa local civil registry offices po.
And when the LCR submits to endorses to PSA, anong kasama dun sa endorsement?
Yung transmittal lang po.
Transmittal lang? Walang ibang documents that would support the transmittal?
Yung file po is nasa local civil registry offices po.
Okay, thank you. Congressman Akop, you're recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. May I know from Madam Roque, you also attended the last hearing, right?
Hindi po ako nakarating nung May 8, Your Honor.
The previous hearing?
Hindi pa po.
First time mo?
Apo.
So, you are certifying that there is no record of Mr. Willie Ong's birth insofar as your office is concerned.
Yes po, Your Honor.
Thank you. Now, PSA, are you aware of a document dated 27 August 2001 from the Office of the Civil Registrar General regarding the request of Mr. Willie Ong for travel abroad? Was requesting for certain from your office files for his birth record. Are you aware of that?
Your Honor, we have po a copy of the certificate.
Tinatanong ko lang, ma'am, kung you're aware of it.
Yes.
And would you say that this is authentic muna?
Yes.
Yes. And what does it say?
Certifying that the birth record of Willie Ong, alleged to have been born on 29 May 1977 in Mikawayang, Bulacan, had negative results.
Had negative results. Pakibasa ulit. Pakituloy nyo para marinig ng ating ibang mga kasamahan.
This is further certifies that civil registry records of births for the year 1977 are intact in the files of the Office of the Local Civil Registrar, the above them locality as per status report of civil registry records submitted to this office on 14 May 1999. Further,
go ahead, ma'am.
Further, verification may therefore be requested in the files of that office.
Now, you are certifying that pursuant to your records, kasi National Statistics Office document to, di ba?
Yes.
The precursor of your office of the PSA. Tama po?
Opo.
Yes. And therefore, pursuant to your records, wala pong ka-record si Mr. Willie Ong.
Yes po.
Yes. That is dated 27 August 2001. Tama?
Yes.
Opo. Now, let's go to another document from the Office of the Municipal Civil Registrar dated August 31, 2001, 4 days after. Are you aware of this, the local civil registrar? It was signed by a certain Mr. Epifanio Areno.
We have a copy, sir.
You have a copy of that?
Yes.
And what does this document say? 4 days after the PSA certified na wala silang records regarding the birth of Mr. Willie Ong.
Sir, the Office of the Municipal Civil Registrar, Mr. Epifanio Areno, has endorsed the copy of the document on 31st August 2001. So yes, this is a regular schedule.
Tignan mo, Iha. Yung date ng PSA is August
27.
August 27, right?
Yes.
Tama?
Yes,
possibly. Yun yung kwan ng PSA. Pero yung document ng na walang record si Mr. William. Tama? Pero sa local civil registrar dated August 31, 2001, ang date of birth ni Mr. Willie Ong ay May 29, 1977. Tama?
Yes, sir.
Oh, paano nangyari 'yon? Sinasabi ng PSA, wala nga silang records of birth dated August 27, 2001, pero 4 days thereafter nag-issue ng document ang local civil register August 31, 2001, nagkaroon na kaagad siya ng birth date.
Sir, may process po tayo ng endorsement if with negative result from PSA. If positive po or may kopya at the local civil registrar, may process po tayo ng endorsement na tinatawag. So this one po is endorsed by the local
civil registrar. Hindi, ang sabi kanina ng local civil registrar, wala nga silang record of birth ni Mr. Willie Ong. First, next question, paano nagkaroon ngayon ng dokumento ang municipal civil registrar August 31, 2001, meron ng birth date si Mr. Willie Ong? Hindi nyo ba naintindihan yung impossibility ng mga ginagawa ninyo? Ha? Nahuhuli kayo doon sa ginagawa ninyo eh. Oh. Kasasabi lang ng local civil registrar to the queries of the Honorable Dan Fernandez kanina na wala ngang record ng birth ni Mr. Willie Ong doon sa LCR. Sinertify din nyo August 27, na wala ngang record. Pero magic, nagkaroon. Turuan nyo nga po kami na paano mag-magic ng ganyan.
Your Honor, the reason why we have the record, because it was validly endorsed to us by the then local civil registrar. We have here the original document, the endorsement letter, dated August 31. This is an original document, Your Honor, bearing the specific signature of the LCR. When we receive this, we verify it with
who is the LCR then?
Mr. Epifanio Areno.
Kaya nga, yun nga sinasabi ko, nag-issue kayo ng certification August 27. Walang record si Mr. Willie Ong.
Your Honor, tama? Yes, Your Honor.
Yes, because teka. Patapusin mo ako. Do you agree with that? Huh?
Yes, Your Honor. We confirm the document.
Yun lang ang gusto ko marinig. Huwag mo nang dagdagan. Dahil baka lalo kang lulubog. Tapos sabi ng local civil registrar, wala silang ka-record. Madam local civil registrar, bakit meron po kayong, meron pirma yung inyong dating civil registrar, si Mr. Epifanio Areno, na merong birth date si Mr. Willie Ong?
Your Honor, hindi ko po siya masagot kung paano po nangyari yun that time. Pero anong time na po yun? Wala nga po. Wala po kami nito. Wala po kami.
Ito yung dokumento eh. Oh, binabasa ko. Tapos sasabihin yung wala. Sabihin naman ng PSA. Meron noong 2001. Alam niyo. Kung titingnan po natin ito, ordinaryo lang ang tingin niyo na problema nito eh. Pero may implications po ito. Ginagawa niyo yung kalokohan. You know, any alien can get a Filipino passport. And I think it is already happening. if we have a DFA representative here, yes, I think nangyayari na po ito, di po ba? Yes. Noon, very reliable yung data ng DFA regarding birth dates of individuals, lalong-lalo na kung may passport. Ngayon, hindi na ako naniniwala pag ganito ang nangyayari. You know? You could just imagine yung value ng passports natin eh bababa in so far as the eyes of other countries are concerned. You can ask DFA about that. Ganun ang nangyayari. Yun ang impact. Napakamura ang ating passport. And you, the agencies concerned, doon nag-originate kung paano in-issuean ng passport ng DFA yung isang alien. That is why sinasabi nila rito na merong national security aspect itong problemang ito. So, paano nyo i-explain yung mga ito? Ha? Huh? Paano? And the PSA, in the last meeting, you committed to form a technical working group to look into this problem. Tama? I have it on record. PSA was directed to create a technical working group to study this issue. Are you aware of that?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. And your report must be submitted, according to this, to be submitted to the committee before the SONA of the President in July 22.
We submit, Your Honor. We will draft.
You better do that.
Yes, Your Honor.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Nakop. Before I acknowledge Congressman Fernandez, let me acknowledge first the presence of our Senior Deputy Speaker, Congressman Dong Gonzales of the 2nd District, 3rd District of Pampanga. Welcome to the committee hearing of the Committee on Dangerous Drugs.
Thank you,
Mr. Chair, a while ago I was asking the pinaka depository department of the PSA, including all those who are manning the sa computer, yung mga
database.
Kasi may head cage yan eh. 'Di ba, ma'am? Telma Kahanding, you've been there for 40 years. Nasa national kayo?
Yes.
National kayo, right? So, kung sa national kayo, alam nyo kung sino yung head nung nagmaman nung database. Sino? Anong pangalan nung nagmaman ng database?
Actually, we have po a partnership with...
With a private entity?
Yung computerization po ng PSA is a PPP project.
Ano po? PPP project? Yung ating mga documents ng ating mga tao with regards sa birth certificate private
yung computer,
partnership
yung
computer, anong company kayo merong PPP
with Unisys po?
Ha?
Unisys Marriage.
Yung Unisys na yon is being owned by whom?
A private
no who owned the Unisys? So sila may hawak ng system.
No, corporation.
Yes, of course. Yung ang database, sila may hawak, Unisys. Who owns Unisys? Unisys. Who owns Unisys? Who owns Unisys?
Unisys Corporation. It is a corporation.
Who owns the corporation? What are the names of the directors, officers?
You will be given a time, sufficient time to verify with this the central
office. Yeah, okay, sige. We will give you time. But what I'm asking is the person who negotiated with PSA. Siyempre, yung may-ari nung Unisys ba? Unisys.
Yes,
siyempre, nakipag-negotiate yon sa inyo. Anong pangalan niya? Baka mamaya foreigner yan. Ay, nababenta na yung ating mga records. Anong pangalan po nung pinaka-presidente ng Unisys? Can you kindly submit to us, kung nahirapan po kayo, submit to us all the names of the directors of the Unisys. And how long had been it, how long have we been in a contract with them? Ilan taon na po tayong may kontrata sa kanila?
We submit, Your Honor.
Sige po. Okay. Can we invite also Mr. Chairman yung yung pinaka-head ng PSA si Dennis Mapa, and also the last three former PSA officials, okay. Mr. Chairman. So, and also all those who are manning the database of the PSA. Okay. Yung controlling mismo ha, yung nagko-control nung pagpasok noong mga nanggagaling sa iba't ibang local civil registrar. We need that, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, Comsec, please take note of the request of Congressman Dan Fernandez.
Mr. Chair.
As to the personalities we will invite in the next scheduled hearing. Before we acknowledge Congressman Gomez, I'd like to share, in relation to the questions propounded by the members to PSA, pakita ko lang itong na-discuss. Very crucial kasi itong information na to, because Empire 999, owned by Mr. Willie Ong, majority owned by Mr. Willie Ong, is now 99% not a Pinoy, not a Filipino. And considering that he's not a Filipino, this is of course violative of the constitution, kasi yung 60-40 equity na violate niya dito, no, more than 40% siya eh. And to add insult to injury, ginamit niya yung pagiging fake niya na Pilipino para makabili ng maraming lupa dito sa ating bansa, no, and particularly in Pampanga. So ito, napaka-importante yung corporation niya. When we traced back, yung some of the incorporators are related also to the other corporations registered in our country. Can we show it on screen? Yung mga, unahin muna natin ito, no? Ito, Mr. Willie Ong, fictitious PSA certification of the existing birth record, no actual record at the LCR. Dahil yun ang sabi ng LCR, at wala namang siyang kopya, na, meron ba siyang Form 102, yung birth certificate, PSA? Wala. So meaning, kagaya nung sinabi nyo kanina, you will immediately cancel. What is there to cancel if he has no birth certificate? No, di ba? So, ano yan? Yung Henry Bigay, okay, one of the incorporators nung Yatay tsaka Omni, sinabi dito, only the name of the mother was entered on the birth certificate. There seems to be a pattern, no? Yung mga Chinese nationals wanting to get Filipino citizenship, ang modus, pinanganak sa isang malayong lugar sa ating mga probinsya, late registration, ang nagpaanak, kumadrona, o midwife, lahat po yan. Yan, no? Yun yung pattern, eh. At pang-apat, doon sa kanilang records that they submit, mothers lang ho yung nakarehistro. Mother or father, hindi mother and father, no? So parang these are all red flags, di ba? Kung tutusin, no? Ngayon, meron dito yung Bernice Yang Tan, I'm sure si Attorney Suwa, who represents Miss Bernice Yang Tan and Denise Kai Yang, no? As one of the incorporators ng Yatay Industrial, nakalagay dito, meron silang timely registration of birth, no? Pero both their parents are Chinese. How come they were able to secure a Filipino citizenship? Kung parehas nilang magulang ay I don't know if Attorney Suwa is aware of that. Attorney.
Your Honor, to my knowledge, Miss Bernice Yang Tan is married to a Filipino. And she acquired Filipino citizenship recently by virtue of the Moya Lim Yao rule, Your Honor.
Okay, I'm not very familiar with that ruling, but when was this?
Your Honor, I think the the marriage was in 2021, Your Honor, and the process of acquiring Filipino citizenship by virtue of marriage to a Filipino under the Moya Limiao rule was processed, I think, 2 years ago, Your Honor.
Well, can we get records of that too? And please ask...
Mr. Chair, can we be educated on that issue? What was
that?
Can
you enlighten us more?
Kasi parang
about
medyo,
ruling?
Anong ruling yun? That's not the ruling of the... Wait. That's not the ruling of our Philippine government. That's the ruling of what?
Supreme Court.
Supreme Court decision.
So, okay. Sige. So... Again, pati si Denise Kayang, by virtue of his being married to a Filipino.
For Denise Kayang, Your Honor, she is a Filipino by virtue of administrative naturalization, duly filed with the Office of the Solicitor General under the, I forgot the exact Republic Act number, but Your Honor.
What year was this?
I don't have the exact date, Your Honor, but I think a few years ago, Your Honor.
Attorney,
Mr. Chair?
Yes, Congressman na ako.
The Supreme Court decision was dated 2 years ago. Did I hear you correct?
No, Your Honor. I think we have officials of the Bureau of Immigration who can elucidate on the Moya Limiao rule, Your Honor. That is for marriage of a Chinese citizen married to a Filipino. They are allowed to acquire Filipino citizenship, Your Honor.
The ruling was in the year 1971.
I'm sorry, Your Honor, I did not recall now, the exact date of the Moya Limiao ruling.
When did Vernice Young get married?
I think 2021 or 2022. I'm not sure of the exact
2021
or 22, Your Honor.
2022.
And then thereafter, she applied for acquisition of Philippine citizenship with the Bureau of Immigration accordingly, Your Honor.
Pursuant to that decision of the Supreme Court.
Yes, they called that the Moya Limiao ruling, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, I would like to request the Bureau of Immigration a report on this para makita natin kung the process was really done in accordance with our protocols.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Akop. Congressman Tambunting, you recognize?
Mr. Chair, may we also request from the lawyer to submit to the committee the OSG application because he mentioned that there was an administrative order declaring here a naturalized citizen. So, and also, may we also have request a copy of the Supreme Court ruling itself so that this can be validated by the committee, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Attorney Sua, please take note of the request of Congressman Tambunting.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. Maraming salamat. Alam nyo kasi, napaka-importante itong isyong itong correct sa birth certificate.
Correct.
At saka yung pagiging Pilipino. Because these people possess Filipino passports. Gaya ng sinabi ni Congressman Akop, nagiging mura na yung Filipino passport in exchange for what? Diba? For something, probably, monetary. Diba? Kasi wala namang gagawa ng ganitong kalokohan na alam nilang labag sa batas kung walang kapalit po ito. So we just like to emphasize that. And with this information we have at hand, medyo nakakaduda at medyo red flags po ito. Kasi droga ho ang pinasok nung taong involved. At bukod sa drogang na-discover natin, meron din po tayong na-discover na ibang anomalya na ginawa rin ng mga the same personalities na ito. Kagaya ho ng paglabag sa batas, sa pagkakaroon ng majority share sa isang kumpanya, more than 40%.
Yes.
At syempre, yung pagbibili ng lupa.
Yes, so, Mr. Chair.
Yes, Congressman.
With regards to your discussion, Mr. Chair, I wanted to interject that if it is true that Mr. Willyong is not a Filipino citizen, then he violated the Constitution. Number one, by being a majority shareholder of a corporation which is not allowed under Philippine law. Second, if it's not a Filipino, then the question is, how come he was able to purchase ilan to? 9, 291 titles, 91 properties. And was that the attorney from a PSA? Was he the one who said na they already have recommendations for the cancellation of titles, PSA? Attorney...
Sige. So kung ganun, now that we have already identified...
So there's a recommendation for cancellation of citizenship? And yeah, is there also a recommendation for a cancellation of titles and sequestration of land in favor of the government?
Sige. What is this PD remedy? Pagka ganyan. PSA. Ah, sorry. Yeah. LRA.
Yes, sir. What the LRA does in this case would be to file an endorsement with the Office of the Solicitor General for the forfeiture of the properties.
Okay. So, pwede ba na, kasi ang normal tendency, no, kapag may ganyan, magbibenta ng mga lupa, kaagad yung mga yan eh. So, pwede bang i-annotate doon sa titulo na merong congressional inquiry in aid of legislation para yung posibleng buyer, titingnan muna kung ano yung mga annotation doon sa title. Pwede ba yan?
Your Honor, yung allowable under the circumstances is an annotation for list pendants. Ibig sabihin po, kailangan may kaso sa court.
Okay.
However, we commit right now na we will monitor the properties.
So there must be a case first before yung list pendants would apply?
Yes, okay. Your Honor.
So in this case, that meron pa tayong ongoing investigation sa congressional inquiry, can we not annotate or put an annotation that subject to the... etc. ng congressional?
Based on an endorsement from us, Your Honor, pwede nang mag-file ng case ang Office of the Solgen, tapos tatakan na namin yung dispute.
Okay, so mas maganda yun. Yes, Congressman Paduano.
Anyway, in line with that purchase of properties of foreign national, actually sa committee ko, it was raised already, Mr. Chairman, and in fact, supposedly before this hearing commenced with regards to, before the period of interpolation comments, I will deliver manifestation that all those documents relating to investigation in my committee in public accounts will be submitted to this committee because interlocking po. No? That's number one. Number two, Mr. Chairman, I will also submit the opinion of the OSG with regards to this matter. Now, but I have now the official reply by OSG signed by OSG Guevara. I will submit it to the committee, Mr. Chairman. But let me ask na lang muna, OSG is present. OSG, please. Please.
By the way, Congressman Paduano and the honorable members of the committee, we have in the other room, in the holding room, the presence of the four Chinese nationals apprehended by BID and Philippine National Police as part of as members of a syndicate in faking citizenship and passports. Nandyan po sila sa likod. We can call them anytime to pursue our questioning.
Let's invite them over, Mr. Chair.
In relation to...
Let's invite lang para while you're asking.
Sige,
na i-prepare na sila.
After the... before that, let me invite you to have your lunch while we're having our committee hearing. The lunch was sponsored by our senior deputy speaker, Don Gonzales. So you can have lunch while we're conducting this hearing. Okay, Congressman Paduano.
Mr. Chairman, OSG, are you present during my hearing with regards to the issue of... land acquisition of foreign nationals and the legal opinion of the OSG was asked by the committee.
Not me personally, Your Honor.
In the last hearing in this committee, the issue also arise. Then the OSG was asked, are you present during the last hearing?
I wasn't, Your Honor.
Mr. Chairman, yun ang problema. Kasi, supposedly, Those resource speakers that is present, previously present, should be present in today's hearing. Kasi paiba-iba ang opinion. As I have observed, Mr. Chairman, sa OSG, paiba-iba ang opinion. Kasi ang pagkatanda ko po, and now I will ask the OSG, last hearing, when the OSG representative was asked about the possible legal remedies of government in this case, ang sagot po, pwedeng forfeiture of such property. We're talking here about a foreign national owning a property or land in this country. Ano pong opinion mo? Kasi last hearing, the opinion is forfeiture.
Can you please state your name, attorney?
Yes, Hector Kalilong, Your Honor.
Have you taken your oath?
No, Your Honor.
Okay, may we ask you to please take your oath? Comsec, please administer the oath of attorney
Hector Kalilong.
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 Please raise your hand, sir. Do you swear to tell the truth and nothing but the truth in this congressional inquiry?
Yes, I do.
Thank you.
Chairman? Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir, Congressman.
Will the lawyer answer my query? Attorney? For example, in the case of Willie Ong, he's now fugitive. And ADT Young, this is also an associate of Willie Ong, but owning a property, and that includes the property of their corporation. Personal property muna. What will be the legal remedy of the government? Of course, PSA will recommend. But what is the opinion of OSG?
Your Honor, escheat or reversion proceedings can be filed, Your Honor.
Sorry?
Escheat or reversion proceedings can be filed.
Reversion?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. Okay, so, Mr. Chairman, just for the record, the answer, ito yung gusto ko marinig. The answer of OSG is pwede po yung reversion process. After the PSA, recommends to OSG.
It is the LRA, Your Honor.
Ah, LRA, sorry. LRA.
Yes, Your Honor.
After the LRA, will recommend to you.
Endorse the case to the OSG.
Okay. Now, question of, can an innocent, can the lawyer or the counsel of that particular person, can he cite question of in good faith? And that, remember, the title was already transferred twice at our price.
I am not sure I understand the question, Your Honor. Do you mean, if I may be clarified, do you mean that when he bought this foreign national, bought the title, he bought it in good faith? Is that
because that is maybe one of the argument of the lawyer
no,
of that
no, Your Honor, it's a good faith in this case. If the foreign national, as a defense, is citing good faith, that he bought the property in good faith, even though he is a foreign national, that is not a defense, Your Honor.
No, but in the case of the original owner selling it to a foreign national.
Your Honor, the seller, meaning he does not know that the buyer is a foreign national, Your Honor.
Yes. Whether he know or not.
If I may be clarified, Your Honor, do you mean by that such defense of good faith on the part of the seller, will it cure the defect?
Yeah, cure the defect. Correct.
I don't think so, Your Honor.
Okay.
Because it is clear that the foreign national cannot buy real property, Your Honor, under the law. No.
Okay. That is your personal opinion, but that is not the position of the OSG. Tama po.
Your Honor, according to the paper given to me from our office, Your Honor, I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, you are referring to a subsequent sale by the foreign national to a Filipino citizen. So we are talking about two sales here, Your Honor, at least. So,
correct.
So the subject property first is sold to a foreign national. That will not be valid.
Okay.
But later on, there is a subsequent sale by the foreign national to a Filipino citizen. Is this what you mean, Your Honor? It would appear from the paper I am holding, Your Honor.
Yeah, that is already one case, a different case.
Yes, Your Honor. And the question is, would the second sale be valid, Your Honor?
Correct.
That's the question. I am not sure if the position paper you made mention earlier, Your Honor, is the same position paper I have here that was given to me.
So please state the position of the OSG. That is the official position of OSG and signed by...
Your Honor, what I have at the moment is was submitted to our Solicitor General for submission. I don't know if this morning what you have was already signed.
Anyway, please state lang the position of OSG in your paper. Wala pa, may problema kasi ito
na pera pa ni Krabs eh.
Mr. Chair, while waiting, may I be allowed to interject with the Jermaine.
Pwede naman siguro at first place.
Oh, at first place.
Are you ready to answer, attorney?
Yes, Your Honor.
Please, kasi nag-abol kami ng oras dito, no?
Yes, Your Honor.
And before you answer, please on the next hearing, you should be the one present, no? Unless the chairman will invite the head of office.
I would be honored, Your Honor, and
tell your principal.
Yes, Your Honor.
That you should be present in the next hearing. Kasi the other representative of your office, wala nga dito. Ang tinatanong ko, mas mabilisan ang sagutin kasi last time, ang sagot niya forfeiture. Now we have now the documents coming from the office signed by no other than the head of office, OSG Guevara.
I understand, Your Honor, but if you would understand my predicament, I cannot tell my principal to tell me to appoint me, Your Honor. It is up to him to choose.
And then you tell him that it is the decision of this committee.
I believe the invitation
and
was sent.
It's up to him
to appoint.
Yeah, of course. But you have to tell him that for consistency of clarifications and answers, dapat ikaw.
I will relay that message, Your Honor.
Thank you. Please proceed.
Yes.
Mr. Chair, if I may. Di ba tapos? Ay, torture to. Torture done.
Sige. Yeah. Attorney.
To answer the question, Your Honor, the OSG cited the case of the United Church Board of World Ministries versus Sebastian. This is government record number L.
Could you please speak closer to the mic?
Yes, the case of the United Church Board of World Ministries versus Sebastian. This is government record number L-34672, decided on 30 March 1988. This was a case of an alien resident who owned properties in the Philippines, devised to an American non-stock corporation. But subsequently, so the Supreme Court sustained the invalidity of such a legacy because they're foreigners. However, upon proof that ownership of the American corporation has passed on to a 100% Filipino corporation, the court ruled the defect in the will was rectified by the subsequent transfer of the property to a 100% owned Filipino-owned corporation. So the reason being, the constitutional prohibition would be inapplicable because the ban's purpose of limiting land ownership to Filipinos would have been achieved. So in this case, Your Honor, the land remained with Filipinos. It was not transferred to. So I believe your question, Your Honor, is why is it that subsequently the sale was recognized valid, or the transfer of ownership was recognized valid, when in the beginning it was owned by a foreigner?
No, but to cut you, that jurisprudence is a separate yung United Church Board of World Ministries, tama po? Versus Sebastian, yun yung kinukulong.
Yes, Your Honor. Yes, Your Honor.
Yeah, that jurisprudence can only be applied if there is an irregularity in the transaction. But in this case, there is a graft cases that was already filed. There is a collusion between the local government, the Chinese national supposedly claiming to own that land, and the former owner. Eh, sinasabi mo kasi, quoting that position, eh kung regular. But this time, there is a pending case in the ombudsman. There is also a pending investigation in the House that hindi pa lumalabas yung committee report namin. Pero ako personally, my conclusion is there is a collusion between the title holder, which is a Filipino, sold to a foreign national, which is now fugitive, and then sold to the government of Mexico, Pampanga. There is the process or the transaction is irregular. So?
Your Honor, in such a case, I was not advised of the position of the office, Your Honor. And I know not of a Supreme Court decision that bears the same facts. And there being as yet no justiciable controversy, I will not dare to give an opinion of what the Supreme Court will say in this case, Your Honor.
So, Mr. Chairman, may we require the OSG to have an official opinion on the next hearing with regards to the issue that I raised?
Well, if that is possible, maybe we can ask the OSG to issue an opinion on the questions raised by Congressman Paduano.
So, kasi Chairman, for the record, I have here now the answer of OSG doon sa committee ko. And ang pag-iintindi ko po, yung sagot nila is not favorable to the direction that we should have with regards to properties that should be reverted back to the government. Now, kasi ang tanong ko kanina, ang question of regularity, presumption of regularity, pwede. But dito kasi, it is already established that, well, in fact, the Well, in fact, sabi ko na may pending case sa ombudsman. Now, ang inahabol natin dito is the property. Kasi there is already one property owned by Mr. Eddie Yang, sabi ko na, which is a fugitive, a foreign national, which was sold to a Filipino in the person of Rudingo. But this Rudingo is still, it has to be established if indeed he's a Filipino. Diba? Eh, kung ganyan yung opinion ng ASG, talong-talo dito yung ano, gobyerno. Talong-talo dito yung mamamayan.
Mr. Chair?
With the indulgence of Congressman Paduano, Congressman Akop, you're recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. May I know if the buyer of the property at issue is also a is a Filipino? Have we established that? Register of Deeds? Are you sure that Mr. Rodingo is a Filipino?
Well, based on the record submitted, Your Honor, he represented that he was a Filipino.
Yun ang yung tinatanong ko kasi, if you look at the rationale of the opinion of the Solicitor General Representative, even so long as the land at issue is transferred to a Filipino, the mistakes are cured. Di po ba, Mr. Solicitor General, that is your opinion? Pursuant to that decision of
it
the...
It would appear from the decision of the Supreme Court, Your Honor.
Yes. So, matanong ko, yung si Mr. Rudingo, Filipino, and from the records you said, Madam, na Filipino siya.
Yes, Your
Honor. Now, may I ask who among the agencies of government would determine whether Mr. Rudingo is a Filipino or not? Kasi kung hindi siya Pilipino, hindi applicable yung kwan, yung decision ng Supreme Court. So we have to know first whether the buyer is truly a Filipino citizen.
So who would have the records of, I'm sure the PSA would have the copy of the birth certificate of Mr. Rudy Ngo. Bureau of Immigration.
Mr. Chair, based on the records of the Bureau of Immigration, Rudingo used a Philippine passport since he started his travel and up to his last arrival on 27 April 2024. He has consistently been using a Philippine passport.
But... would that guarantee that he is a Filipino citizen?
No, Your Honor. We can only guarantee that he used a Philippine passport during his travel.
That is why I asked that question.
Yes, sir.
Which agency of government can definitely say that Mr. Rodingo is a Filipino? Kasi yun ang dapat ma-establish natin before the Solicitor General can use or anchor his answers in the decision of the Supreme Court. Di ba?
Yeah, because I agree with Congressman Ako, because in these personalities that we have stated earlier, they were misrepresentations. They are
Mr.
Chinese,
Chair,
but
Chair,
they are claiming to be Pinoys
Mr.
or
Chair,
Filipinos.
May I move that we invite this Rudingo? Because I think this will follow a bad precedent if ever that we allow, if ever that this guy is a Chinese citizen and bought the property from a Chinese citizen as well, eh, pinaiikot lamang tayo ng mga to. So, let's invite this Rudingo, Mr. Chairman.
Chairman.
Mr. Okay, with the indulgence of Congressman Akop. Congressman Akop has the floor. Please continue, Congressman Akop.
PSA, can you submit the records that you have pertaining to a certain Mr. Rodingo?
Yes, Your Honor. We will submit a document, Your Honor.
Yes, para makita natin. Kasi parang kayo lang ang makapagsasabi kung Pilipino siya o hindi eh.
Yes, Your Honor. We submit.
Yes.
Thank you, Chairman. Thank you, Chairman. In a way, last one to Chairman. Kasi ito, in the case of Willie Ong, Chairman, ito nangyari na kay Edith Yang. Soljen, please. Ito nangyari kay Eddie Yang, which is also an associate of Willie Ong.
doon sa IMPAR 999. Now, there are properties now. Well, in fact, if the chair will allow me to discuss later the all the properties of and bank transactions of Willie Ong, there is an exigency to act on it. Kasi baka ang kaso na nangyari kay Eddie Yang, mangyari din. Properties of Willie Ong as of now has not yet been sold. Now, LRA, I think you have to act on it. You recommend to OSG to have an adverse claim dun sa lahat na property ni Willie Ong.
Your Honor, we will follow up on our request to the OSG on this matter.
When
I get back to the office, Your Honor.
Please. Yes, ganon sir. Din po kay Eddie Yang. Kasi Eddie Yang was already established that he is a Chinese citizen using Chinese passport. And that passport he's holding, a Filipino passport, he's not using it for the past several years. Eh, BID na mismo ang nagbigay ng record. Now, we are not doing something about it. And this is the interest of this country and the people of this country. Matagal na to, isang taon na to eh. Eh, sumalubong lang tong hearing ni Chairman Barber because of the drugs. And I hope OSG, gawan nyo ng paraan. Hindi pwede to. Well, in fact, kaya nga, gusto ko sana si Guevara na mismo nandito eh. He was present yesterday doon sa AGK. Tinanong ko rin siya. But now, I think, Chairman, kasi iba yung opinion niya eh. Pinirmahan niya. Eh, ang sinasabi ko, question of presumption of regularity. Okay yun. Pero in this case, may case sa ombudsman. Magkaiba to. Well, in fact, the mayor of Mexico, Pampanga, was already dismissed twice. Eh, wala. Sorry, Chairman, no? Napaka-emotional ko, pero ay, parang walang ginagawa yung mga agencies natin to help us. This is not only an inquiry in aid of legislation. This is also part of our oversight function. How this agency perform their mandate. Kaya, LRA, please.
Yes, Your Honor, we commit to follow up.
When I get dalawa back, po yun. Si Chair. The properties of Willie Long and the properties of Eddie Tiang.
Yes, sir.
And baka yung iba to follow na yun. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chair, I would like to agree with ano, Congressman Paduano, Chairman at Paduano, kasi established na naman natin eh, nandiyan ang SEC, tapos si Willie Ong, hindi naman Pilipino, Chinese, 45% siya. Si Jack Yang, hindi rin Pilipino, 5% siya. Si Eddie Yang, 5%, 55% sila in violation of the 60-40 ruling of owning the properties. And I think it is incumbent upon the, sa OSG. Attorney, makinig ka naman. Mag-ano kayo ng adverse claim na dito para mahabol natin tong mga taong ito na binili yung ating mga properties knowingly na hindi naman sila mga Pilipinos. Hindi ba nakikita na ang nangyayari po dito ay nagiging province na tayo ng China? Sa dami ng mga properties na binibili nila, 292 titles dito pa lamang sa Empire 999. Oh, wala pa yung Golden Sun, wala pa yung Pulwin, wala pa yung Yatay Industrial Park, Yatay International, Omni. O ano pa yung hindi namin alam? Ano magiging ano natin dito? Magiging parte na tayo ng China. Alam nyo ba yun? Yun ang repercussion dito and we have to do something about it. And Attorney Suwa, kanina may binanggit ka, so yung Bernice, ang napangasawa, si Dennis Tam. Is that right?
Denise is the sister of Bernice, Your Honor.
Oh, sino yung napangasawa niya na sinasabi mong Pilipina?
The name there is Tan. I do not have the details.
So anong pangalan nung ang napangasawa ka mo kaya siya na legitimized as a Filipino because yes. she married a Filipino husband.
Yes, Your Honor.
How sure are we that he is also a Filipino? He's really a Filipino.
I am not in a position.
Ayun. Same situation kung kay Rudy Ngo. Hindi rin natin alam. Hindi nyo napapansin? Ngo, Hong, Si, Yang, An, Ni, Ting, lahat na Chinese na. Invading na to.
invasion ang pinagagawa natin dito, attorney. So we hope that you together with Secretary Guevara, you discuss this truthfully, honestly, and with the love of the country. Kasi ibang sitwasyon na itong pinag-uusapan natin dito. Okay?
Yes, Your Honor. I think it is of record that the Solicitor General's office have been consistently acting on the endorsements of the LRA since 1901, Your Honor. So
inconsistently?
As soon as the LRA endorses
attorney,
this
case. Attorney, with your indulgence, inconsistently?
Consistently.
Don't be a part of those people who are trying to sell our country. We have new Makapilis, huh? And trying to sell the authentic identity of the Filipinos. Yun ang nangyayari sa atin. We are selling the identity of the Filipinos for a cheap price. PSA, you need to reform. Kitang-kita na namin dito sa kongresong ito, sa committee na to, kung sino ang nagbebenta ng prescribed identity of the Filipinos. Kakaunti pa lang itong pinag-uusapan natin. We don't know yet. If we will be able to find out the database of that Ulysses, we will be able to find out ilan ang nagbenta ng identity ng mga Pilipino.
Thank you, Your Honor. OSG, ang sabi lang naman ni Honorable Paduano, kung meron pa tayong pwedeng gawin na paraan na legal, in spite of the fact na merong ruling ang Korte Suprema, ang sinasabi lang naman ng Korte Suprema it solved yung problem of constitutionality, di ba? But are we bereft of any legal actions doon sa mga transactions na hindi tama?
There are remedies, Your Honor.
Yes, yun nga yung tinatanong ni Honorable Paduano kanina. Yes. Kaya tuloy, nasasabi na wala kayong ginagawa eh. Pero, di ba?
Your Honor, I agree with what you're saying. But if you notice, I wanted to be clarified before answering the question. If the question was pertaining to this in particular, and if he's referring to, because he's saying that the Solicitor General already had issued an opinion, and then this is the opinion that he is quoting. But there are remedies, Your Honor, as I mentioned earlier, for example, reversion.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the cancellation of the title issued to a foreign national, Your Honor.
Or as the Honorable Fernandez stated, can the state not file an adverse claim? Oh, you know. Sinabi, narinig mo naman si Honorable Fernandez.
It would be the reversion, Your Honor, is our position. That the property that was the titled property, titled to a foreign national, that should be cancelled and the ownership would revert to the state.
To the state?
Yes.
Okay. I leave it at that. But insofar as the decision of the Supreme Court is concerned, it only ruled on the constitutionality of...
constitutional ban, Your Honor, of prohibiting foreign ownership of real property.
Because that was the issue at hand.
Yes.
Yeah.
And in this case, the real property did not go out of the Philippines.
Yes.
It remained in the ownership of a Filipino citizen.
Yes.
Not go out.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, may I go to Attorney Su?